Hello and welcome to our presentation, Optimizing the Workflow Configuration. I will begin by showing you the methods for nesting files and media optimization. I will demonstrate importing and exporting media profiles and explain the difference between OML and PRNINST files, how to add and configure additional printers, and add new page sizes. We'll discuss the importance of setting printer-specific controls. Let's begin with nesting files to get the most out of our media area. In the RIP queue, I can see that I have several jobs in the jobs ready to print area. As I highlight the printer on the far right side, I can see printer-specific information, and I can see the preview of how these jobs are going to be nested or optimized on this media. Let's take a look at how to make changes to this. To start, I have the printer selected, and I will select the Change button. Change Media and Placement menu appears, and here my placement strategy is showing as Conserve Media Setting. What this reflects is that files will be ripped and printed when I select the Print Now button. Printing will not begin automatically. In the pull-down menu, there are other options such as Group Jobs Together. This strategy will print jobs on a strict priority basis for our jobs ready to print order. The first file will print first, the second, and so forth. The jobs will not be rotated and will print based on the list order of our queue. Another placement strategy we have is print jobs individually. Upon making this selection, the status would change from print now to being an automatic flow of jobs. As soon as jobs enter the RIP, they are processed and immediately sent to the printer to print. You would use this placement strategy if you had a need for continuous flow of jobs to RIP and print, such as large tiles or full-size prints. The last choice for placement is Futoba, Dicus, and Flexa cutter marks, and this would produce those type of cutter marks around each print job. This would be used if the job needed to be cut for those specific models. I will go back to Conserve Media, and on the right, select Setup. Here I can control settings for the placement strategy that I have selected. I can change from a manual print trigger to an automated style by either time-based start or area-based start options. I can indicate print to start after a certain amount of time, or after a specific percentage full on the media, which is displayed here on the far right in percentage full. I can control justification of job placement left, center, or right. I can set a non-printing area offset from top or left. By checking on left or right gutter and entering in an amount, I will get a non-printing area of jobs. However, I will have each ink spray or print a small patch to keep the head inks flowing. If flip every other tile is activated on and tile jobs are being printed, then every other tile would be rotated 180 degrees. In the Options tab, the checkbox is on for print all rows at a time. And in the preview, it is displayed as such, making it easy for the finishing person to cut apart jobs very easily. This is giving a percentage full of 71% value. I will disable print all rows at a time, and I will activate best fit and allow rotate. Then I'll click OK, and I will have the display refresh. Now the jobs preview displays the settings. To get the most out of our media usage, and the percentage full is now set to 83%. So those settings are based on what's most important to you, getting the most out of your media, which may take a little longer for the finishing person to cut apart the jobs, or print all rows at a time to make this task faster. Note that all settings can be on at the same time as well. Space between copies is the amount around the job that will be media only, or distance between prints. Cutter mark darkness is a gradual progression to make the marbs darker, and this is on a 1-4 sliding scale, 4 being the darkest. And the last setting is percent to cash before printing. Note the default is set to 0. This option allows you to control when the processed information is sent to the printer. When this is set to 0, information is sent to the printer as fast as possible. When this is set to 100%, the job will be processed completely first and then sent to the printer. I will select OK and return to the placement strategy. Again, to review the options, conserve media, printing will take place when the Print Now button is selected. Group jobs together is a strict priority basis on the list order of our jobs ready to print queue. And print jobs individually would automatically rip and print and rip and print and communicate to our device automatically on the fly. Last choice, Fotoba Digus and Flexa Cutter Marks are specific, putting marks around for those cutter models. So again, to make placement choices, I need to select the printer and select change on the far right side. I can select my placement, then select setup to configure it further. Now let's look at exporting and importing media profiles. To do this, I will select the printer and I will also select configure printer. This will stop our processing. I will select yes, as I am not printing or ripping. Notice the media tab. This will give us a list of all media profiles that are currently available for this printer. These were loaded at the time the printer was installed. I can export or import these media profiles, which will create an OML or Onyx media library file. I will select export, and then I can make the necessary selections of which profiles I would like to export. Notice the file name is based on my printer name for the Canon printer I have. I will save and export the OMLs. This is a backup of the profile data. I can save this off of my RIP computer and archive this to a file server. Should someone delete or overwrite a profile, I can import this profile again. This is just the profile for a specific media. I have another method of backing up profiles and more by creating a PRNINST file. This will contain not only the profiles, but will contain the quick sets and the printer drivers. I will show you this step next. I will select File, then Manage Printers. This too will warn us about stopping our processing. Again, I am not ripping or printing, so I will answer yes. In the Printer Manager window, I can see my printer device and I can select that, and in the lower right corner, I can create a PRNINST. A PRNINST is the printer driver, profiles or OMLs, and quick sets all in one file, identified as a PRNINST or printer installer. These tabs represent the items that will be included, and you can make your selections as needed. I will select Next and browse to where the file should go. Remember, just as before, you would want to save this and have this saved or backed up onto another computer choice, such as a file server. We can see that there are two methods for backing up our data. One as an OML from Configure Printer Media tab Export. This is just the media profiles. And two as File Manage Printer and create a PRNINST file. This is the media profiles, quick sets, and the printer driver. Now let's say your company purchased a new printer. Let's go over the steps to add a new printer. Before I install the new printer, I will need to quit the RIP software, so I'm just going to do that for now. Next, I need the printer driver, And one way I can get this is through the Printer and Profile Download Manager software. This is located in the Programs area of the RIB software. All Programs, search for your RIB product, see the Printer and Profile Download Manager. This will launch the software that will allow us to access and download the printer driver. Now I start with making choices from the very top by selecting the version we are at. This is very important. If you do not know what version you are at, in the RIP, go to Help, About RIP Software, and the splash screen will display the key number and version. Next, select the manufacturer of the printer you are installing. Then select the model number or name. And now the list of profiles available for that printer will display below. I can select the ones I want based on medias, or I can select them all. The Advanced tab is just one method to sort media choices. Here again, you may want all profiles. I will select Download Now and browse to where I want this printer driver to be downloaded to. When the download is complete, I will continue to the next step, which is installing this printer driver to the RIP. Onyx has an Install Printer application, which is located in the Programs area of the RIP software. Select Install Printer. Now that launches, and I can either browse for the newly downloaded printer driver or PRNINST, or I can drag and drop into the installer window. I will check on to select and install. A very nice feature of the RIP is as soon as it's done processing the installation of the driver and I select finish, the RIP will start and I'll be prompted to configure this newly added device. Depending on the printer model, you will have several different communication methods. Select the method that you want to communicate to the printer, as for example, TCP/IP, then select Configure. Enter in information and test for connectivity. The response should come back with valid IP address found. Since I do not have this printer, I am going to select Print to File. Now I'll select OK. Now the printer is configured to communicate, and the next step is to select the printer and then on the right side, change, and set the media type that is loaded on the printer, the roll size, and decide on the placement strategy you would like to use. Let's review. I downloaded the PRNINST file, which contains the printer driver, media profiles, and a default quick set through the Printer and Profile Download Manager software. Once downloaded, I installed the printer driver through Install Printer software. I was immediately prompted to configure communication to the printer, for example, by TCP/IP. Once configured and communication was successful, I needed to identify the media type loaded on the printer, as well as the roll size, and set my placement strategy. Selecting change brought me into that menu of choices. If I need to add a roll size that is not commonly available, I would go to Configure Printer, say yes to stopping my processing as I am not printing or ripping. Then I will select page size. Here I can add and enter in the proper size for the roll I am adding. Now this will be available in my roll size menu. In Configure Printer, I can also go to the Media tab and Options. And if you need to turn on any specific settings, such as the cutter, you can make that choice here. You also have other additional adjustments for the printer if needed. Keep in mind, each printer will have its own set of options here. It depends on the printer, and you can consult with the printer manufacturers about these settings. You may also have more than one mode for the media. Mode options would allow us to further control settings if needed. The first tab we see is for quick sets. It is here that I can create a new quick set or edit one. I might decide to have a quick set to identify a specific media type. Or possibly I want to identify a quick set for a specific cutter model. This will streamline my processing time, as the quick set will apply settings to the job as it is ripped, and saving those steps from me having to do them manually in Job Editor. So now I have the newly added and configured printer ready to go. Over time, if you create new profiles or quick sets, you may want to revisit backing up the printer as a PRNINST again. This way you will have the latest updates to your backup. This will conclude our presentation on optimizing the workflow configuration. For more information about Onyx products, please visit our website at onyxgfx.com.